Autumn Hamilton. I am back today to give you guys my June favorites. I've never done one of these videos before, but I watch them all the time, like every month. And yeah, I just wanted to do one for you guys. So this month I bought a lot of things. I spent a lot of money that I probably didn't need to. A lot to me may not be a lot to other people. I really tried to like stick to a budget. I tried to save money where I can. I tried to like use Afterpay on the stuff that I'm like kind of splurging on so that it's not like as much all at once. So that is what I did. And I'm just gonna get right into it. I'm just gonna go through all the things that, well, all the things that I bought in June that are like my new faves, like that I use every time I need to use that thing. So let's get into it. First, I got the Herbal Essences Revel in Lush Aromas Color Me Happy Shampoo and Conditioners. If you've been watching my videos, you know that my hair has been pink a lot recently. It's kind of like a weird faded, like part blonde, part pink, part red kind of combo going on right now. It's been a while since I dyed it. But yeah, so I got these because I wanted them to help keep the color in my hair, and I really loved the colors of them. I like that they're pink. I like that my hair is pink. I've been like loving pink lately, if you can't tell. Loving pink. So I got those. I have used the same shampoo and conditioner for probably like 10 years or so. I always use the Tresemme Split Remedy shampoo and conditioner. Always, always, always. Not anymore. Not anymore. Starting this month, I use those Herbal Essences, and I really dig them. I think they're really pretty. They smell really good. They're more affordable, and they worked, as far as I could tell, for me. So there is that. My next favorite thing that I got this month were these lashes. Lashes are like a sort of a new thing for me. I never really could figure them out until recently. So if you, like me, are kind of like new to the lash game and you don't want to go with anything super big or crazy, I really recommend these Ardell Naked Lashes. These are the 422, and they are so gorgeous and just like wispy and just, they're amazing. Like, I put them on and I feel like a fairy. Like, I don't know, they're not like super heavy and like bulky or anything like that. They're just like so like wispy and light and like just look so girly and dainty, and I love them. I think they're so pretty. I didn't put them on because I wanted to show you what they look like kind of, you know, up close and personal. So those are those lashes. I really dig them. Go get you some. Next, I got this IT Cosmetics brush. I have never had a single IT Cosmetics anything before I had this brush. I kept the little thing that it goes in because I think it's really nice for keeping its shape, but I love how big this thing is. Like, it takes like, done. Like, it takes 2 seconds to put powder on, and I love it so much. I literally will just say that I'm getting my makeup, the rest of the makeup off of it, but I really just like want to use it everywhere. I don't know. It's so soft. It's so fluffy. It's so big. And I love it. I don't know. I love the handle on it too. Like, the amount of control that you have from this kind of shape in this handle. I'm not really sure what's so special about it, but it feels so good, like, in your hand. You have like so much control. Love it. Love it. Love it. Love it. Love this brush. Oh, and by the way, it is a 211 all over powder brush from IT Cosmetics brushes. Okay. The next thing that I got this month that I'm really loving is the KVD Vegan Beauty Locket Foundation. This is a little bit dark for me right now. I actually just used concealer on my face and like contour and stuff today. I didn't actually use a foundation today, because if I was, I would be using this. This is the shade Light 48 Neutral. And when I have my Saint Tropez tanning stuff on, it's like perfect for my skin tone. But I love how matte it is and I love how long lasting it is. Like, it's definitely a locket foundation. I put it on, and with the heat that we have going on here in Oklahoma right now, you need something that's not literally going to melt off your face. And that's this. It works. I love it. The next things I got, I'm like obsessed with. I literally walked by them in, and I like saw them in the aisle at Walmart, and I was like walking, saw them, whoop. I had to have them. Like, I bought all five of these shades. I could not live without them, and they're so affordable. Had to get them. So these are the LA Colors Gel Extreme Shine Nail Polish. Do you see the gorgeousness in the colors of these? Like, do you see how gorgeous these colors are? So there's those three. There's this super pretty pink. And then I got this really gorgeous nude, and it has gold, gold specks in it, not like glitter, because they're really tiny. Like, you can almost barely see them, but this nude is so gorgeous. I'm so obsessed. I'm so obsessed that I couldn't decide what color to use first. So I just used all three of the like warm colored ones, and then I put the blue on my toes, and then I haven't used the nude one yet, but like, it's gorgeous. And I did these nails like 2 weeks ago or something like that, and like, they haven't chipped. They're broken, but the paint hasn't chipped. It's good stuff. Next thing I got, I'm having sort of a love-hate relationship with. Sometimes whenever I use it, I'm like, this is so cute, I love it. It works so well. Why don't I do this all the time? And then sometimes I use it and I'm like, this was a really bad idea and I just ruined my whole makeup. So if you've watched my Instagram stories, you might have noticed this, because I've shown the times that I ruined my makeup. But if you can figure it out, faux freckles with this Magic Root Cover Up by L'Oreal are so cute. You just have to figure it out. So basically what you do is, it has like a tip like this on it. You shake it up really good, and then you press down the thing, but only so barely enough to where it just kind of like sputters out. And you can kind of see like on the top how it sputters out like that, and then it like kind of falls. So that's what you want it to do. You want it to just like barely like splatter on your face. If you press it too hard though, then it literally just looks like a... And I've done that. And it's not fun. And it doesn't come off very easy. So practice. I recommend practicing. But if you practice and you get it to work, it is really cute. So there's that. The next things I got from Target. And these I just think are so cute. They are little kind of barrette. Are they barrettes? Not really, like, just, they're just like clippies. They're this kind of clippy. They're so cute. And I love this kind of like turtle shell design on this one. And I love how just like basic and chic this one is. And it's a rose gold metal on them, which I think is so cute. And I've been wearing them just like at night whenever I've been braiding my hair just straight down my back at night, and I just got it cut, so it's like, it's not a long braid, but because it's not a long braid, some pieces like fall in the front, so I like to take some of like the longer pieces that won't fit in the braid, pull them back, and then I'll just like put the clip just at the top of the braid, kind of at the base of it, and then just let like the front pieces like fall, and then have that in the back with a braid. It looks so cute, and it's so simple and so easy, and it just kind of like makes my nighttime, I don't care hair look like actually cute. So yeah, I thought those were really adorable, and I just went ahead and picked those up from Target. The next things I got from Walmart, and I actually saw these on a different YouTuber's video, and I had to go out and get them. So these are from Walmart. They're not necessarily like beauty products, but if you are a lady and are tired of paying a whole bunch of money for clothes for no reason, then go get these. So these are some wireless, like wireless push-up bras with like the tiniest amount of padding in them. There's no wire at all, and they're so comfortable and so affordable. And I got them in nude and black, and they're so affordable, and they're so cute, and they're so comfortable. Listen, I am so tired of paying way too much money for stuff that I'm literally walking around and I'm being like, I cannot wait to take this off. Like, thinking the whole day in the back of my head, like, I cannot wait to take this off. I'm tired of it. I'm too old for that. I'm 24 years old. I spent too long being uncomfortable. I'm not doing it anymore. So, Walmart. I also got this one, which is actually my favorite, because it's actually just a bralette, which is usually what I wear. So it's just this like black little V-neck bralette, and you can see that it's like ribbed. I've already worn it like multiple times, and I've washed it like a whole bunch, so it's not like new or anything. But I did get it this month, and I've already worn it that many times, so it's comfortable and it's cute. But you can see it's kind of like got like a ribbed material, which makes it look a little bit nicer, and it's super thick, so it's like it has support. It's really nice. So there's that bra. Definitely recommend that one for sure. And then, y'all, I went to 4 Walmarts to get this tank top. This tank top looks basic. This tank top looks like nothing special. It was like $3 at Walmart. It's not see-through. It's thick. It has a nice strap. It's super comfortable. It's really soft. It's a nice material. And $3. I mean, need I say more? I got a white one, and then I also got a nude one that I couldn't find, but it's like a really pretty, like warm nude, and it looks so nice. So I've been wearing like those tank tops with sweatpants and just like feeling cute, even though I'm just wearing like a tank top and sweatpants. But I'm telling you guys, these tank tops are so nice. They fit so well, and like I said, go get you one. So I'm getting towards the end of the video. Sorry. But the next thing that I got that I have been obsessed with is nothing new to most of you probably, but this is a microfiber hair towel. I got it off Amazon. It is the Euler Tex hair turban. Listen, I used to wash my hair once a week. I wash my hair like every 3 days now. It's so easy to just put my hair up in this thing and then walk around for like 30 minutes and not have to deal with wet hair dripping down my back and like sticking to my face and being so annoying while I'm trying to make dinner and all the stuff. So I'm really loving that I can just put that on, put it on my head, and it's not moving around, it's not falling off, it's not big and bulky. It's not ugly. Like, I really love it. And it's better for your hair, and it dries it faster. So, loving that. These two things came in yesterday, and I am already obsessed. So one of them is a hot take, one of them is not such a hot take, but they're both really awesome and new to me. So that's why they're my favorites, because this video is about me and my favorites. Just kidding. So I splurged. I got 2 JSC palettes. They're so amazing. Like, this does them no justice. They're so gorgeous. Like, the weight of these just feel like luxuriousness, and I love it. Like, these are so amazing. Okay, so just show them off to you. This one is the Jawbreaker palette, and it is not new. It's been out for a while, I'm pretty sure, but it's so pretty. Like, if you like color like I do, this palette's for you. It's so gorgeous. And I hesitated to buy it because I have the James Charles Morphe palette, and I'm like, oh, it's so colorful. Like, how many colors can you really have? Maybe I won't buy it. But I did, and I'm so glad I did, because the colors are not the same. Like, the shimmers compared to the mattes, compared to the tones and the shades and the everything. Like, they're not the same at all. At all. So, totally justified. And then I also got the cremated palette. This one is actually newer. So, this is what it looks like. It is so pretty. I've only used this one, and this one so far, but they are so gorgeous. I really like the stamps. I love the like marbling of the palette. I think that's so pretty. The one thing I don't like about this palette is the front. I love Jeffree Star and I think he's so gorgeous and amazing and just so talented, but there's something about this cover on this palette that just doesn't jive with me super well, like especially for it being called the cremated palette. I feel like there's so many options for cool graphics and stuff that you can do for the front of a palette that's called cremated, and for it to just be like Jeffree like dissolving into ashes, like that's a cool concept, but I feel like it just could have gone like that extra step further somehow. I don't know how, because that's not my job and I'm not getting paid to do that, but somebody could have done that. Yeah, they could have. I even like if the front of it was just this, like with the eye and like dissolving into the ashes, like that is dope. That would be cooler. I would be down with that. I might even cut this out of here and like Mod Podge it to the front. Is that a bad idea? But yeah, so there's those palettes. I'm obsessed. I'm definitely gonna be using them a lot. Some other things that I got the day before yesterday, I'm in love with, but I don't feel like taking the time in this video to go through all of those. So, what? Needy? 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 Are you needy? So ultimately I did another Shein haul. I bought a lot of clothes on Shein about a month or so ago, and they finally came in the day before yesterday. And this is the most impressive Shein order that I've made so far, and I'm super happy with most of them. There's a few things that I'm gonna be sending back most likely, but for the most part I was like obsessed with most of the clothes. Like, they're so cute and so affordable. If you haven't ordered off Shein, my advice would be that you're gonna be sending stuff back. You just are. There's some stuff that you'll get and it'll be a small, and you'll have seven other things that are small and they'll fit perfectly, but then like you'll have one small and it's like way too big and you're like, why? And then you just send that back and they give you a refund. It's so easy, and for how affordable it is, it's worth it to me, in my opinion. So yeah, but I'm gonna do a separate Shein haul video and show you guys the stuff that I got, because they're so cute and I'm like obsessed. One of them though, I will show you, is this little outfit. This is a, see if I can stand on my, standing on my chair, guys, to show you guys this. So this is a little pink, like, outfit. I don't know, it's a two-piece outfit, it's not that hard, but yeah, it's got this like just like ruched top on the shorts. I think is so cute. They're so comfortable. I like that the shorts are like a little bit longer and flowy, so it's not like showing everything. Like, they're really comfortable, but they're also really cute. They fit really well. And then I love the top. I didn't really realize that I actually bought four tops just like this in different colors, but I did. And I'm not mad about it, because they're super cute and they fit really well, and I love the vibe and I feel like so free, especially in this arm, I feel so free. But yeah, so I got those. And the last thing that I did this month that cost me the most money that I haven't paid yet because I put it on a credit card was these lips. I don't know if you noticed, but I did get them filled. I went to Skin Lab Injectables in OKC. I love them so much. I would go get more if it wasn't so expensive, but I'm like obsessed. Like, tell me they're not cute. I have always wanted lip fillers, always, always, always. I don't know why, just my whole life. I was like, I wasn't meant to have lips this small. just wasn't. My face is like too round for lips being this small. Like my eyes are kind of like big and round, and my lips were just like they were like half there. And I don't like doing stuff just halfway, so I just got them full. So yeah, I believe that's it. I think that is all that I got that I can remember that I actually enjoyed. So that's all I know. If you guys have any other things that you got for the month of June that you're just like obsessed with or whatever, then leave me a comment and let me know what I need, because maybe it'll be in my July favorites video. Without further ado, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for spending this quality time with me in your quarantine while I'm bored, and you're probably bored too. But yeah, I guess I'm just gonna, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Probably, I don't know. I need a nap is what I really need. Because June kicked my ass. Thank you so much for watching.